biggest mountain in Lyngen is Jekkevare, and Jekkevare has a south face, and it's really big.
The south face, it's the kind of run that the steep skiing legend Andreas Fransson stood on top of, but found too sketchy to ride, before his fatal accident on a mountain that he judged to be less serious. And now, you know, my good friend and main riding partner, Christer, wants to do it.
So I'm, I've been skiing a long time now. And it feels like the people I ride with, they sort of tend to like gravitate away from free ride and into steep skiing. And now I see Christer like being more and more attracted to that and going down that path. And he has been the past 4 years like one of my main partners in the mountain.
That's epic.
And we have aligned perfectly on what we've been wanting to do.
We've just been on the roll, it feels like.
That was amazing.
We got to ride some really cool stuff. Like, really cool stuff. But this season I felt like, yeah, I want to do myself. Like, I want to do the things I want to do. Like, I want to bring two ice axes and like the big crampons and like do a bit of climbing, do a rappel, steep skiing, having like death anxiety.
Free ride is not without risk, but just like the level of risk in steep skiing is just beyond.
All right, a little bit of icy steeps.
I mean, you're basically free soloing, but not on rock that stays there. You're free soloing on snow and you have a huge cliff below you. If you mess up and you've miscalculated the snowpack, you're just gone.
So last season, Nico got a girlfriend.
Ingen snöskred.
No snöskred for you.
And he got soft.
I want to go home to my girlfriend.
This season, he got dumped.
Yeah.
And he got even softer.
I've just come to realize that I don't get nearly the same joy doing slow jump turns over death exposure as I do when I free ride.
Pushing my athletic ability as opposed to pushing my, you know, knowledge about how to tie a knot.
I'm the worst at this. You remember the knot?
That's not what I'm looking for. But at the same time, there's this melancholy, right? I'm sad to lose my riding buddy.
Like, now we're going on the same glacier camping trip, but I want to ride lines like Kråketornan, where a fall or an avalanche most likely won't kill you, while Christer's goals are
to have a good look at the south face, and I have some other lines, like on the east side of Jekkevare, I want to ride. You need to accept the risk you're gonna take, because it's super exposed with cornices, with seracs, with everything.
Og se her! Her er Sørlingen da.
Tenk at vi skal sove med utsikt til andre siden av fjellet.
Ja, det blir fett. Men jo, så nice at du kan være med da.
Ja.
Du kan være på litt sånn her ikke-dø-programmet.
Positur.
Ja, det var funnig, for jeg skjønte bare på han Chris, han skulle opp. Han har de her linjene i hodet sitt. Så altså, jeg kan ikke, jeg må ha en annen partner.
Så jeg brought Erik til å ride the free ride lines.
I'm Erik Kvalo. I'm 30 years old now. Holy shit.
Whereas Christer and Evan are like on the steep mission.
I might need some help with this one.
I think it's like a backpack kind of. Where does this go?
Yeah, last time we tried to do a mission like this was 2012, so 10 years ago. Pulling sleds up a big glacier. And it was such a mess. We like caught in a snowstorm, had to like bury all our gear. And I ended up just like taking everything out of the sleds and carrying it up because it was too steep. But now we've looked on the map and it's like 10 kilometers of like really flat, up to like 700 meters, so should be good.
We're a big crew, we're gonna have the big, the best glacier camp.
Cursor is big time now, so he has like his own show going over there with Vetle.
There's so many cameras.
10 kilometers of this
easy.
To be able to do a camp like this in Norway, like, there's no motorized access here. So you are human powered. You're not allowed to take a snowmobile or a helicopter into these places.
Okay, obstacle.
The approach was horrible.
This is my situation right here.
Not the best sled terrain.
And it turns into kind of like a little bit of a shit show.
So we take one sled, two people, we get them all up. You're gonna have to earn the lines up here.
Yeah.
And we're in the very beginning of the trip, so I'm like, is this gonna be the whole day?
Eivind, he just carries it. Not a big deal. Strong man.
Top side, boys.
Can we take on skis, Nico?
Yeah, I think that was the worst of it. Are you seeing what I'm seeing right now?
The promised land.
Been kind of brutal, to be honest. I thought it would be more chill. You don't need a lot of incline before these sleds are heavy.
Now I'm kind of regretting bringing 80 energy bars.
80!
Okay. Well, I think we might make it before dark, don't you think?
Jeg tror ikke vi har gjort det verste, altså. Du kjente noe de oppoverbakkene her.
Ja.
Ja, vi har 400 høydemeter igjen.
Ja, vi på 200.
Ah, satan! What the hell, that's a big uphill. What do you think, Eivind?
Ah, it's...
that's steep.
Ah, but let's do some work then.
Yeah, let's put in the work.
I love putting in work.
Krister's working. I'm getting worked. Thanks for pushing up there, Krister.
No problem.
So close now. I feel like it's just like the last little hill.
There's some cool stuff here. Holy shit.
I think this is the spot.
Can't wait for tomorrow. Have a cup of coffee in camp. Watching the sun set on the south face of Jekkevare.
So that tired me out. I was so done when I got up there.
Yeah, I'm pretty done right now. I just want to get in my tent.
You're a trooper.
I'm dead.
It's like getting to the music festival and you've secured the best spot. Right between all the best venues.
And then it's kind of funny, like Eivind's girlfriend Emma and Krister's girlfriend Thea is coming in later.
Hello, gutta!
Sånn det. Med kjærligheten. Klarer ikke en natt uten.
Nei, det for dumt.
You know, we've struggled to get up this valley.
Både Eivind og Krister inne bare, nei,
det går ikke.
Altså, det kan bli jævlig vanskelig med en arm, altså.
Tia, du må bare Emma som pulk, og det blir helt jævlig. Og vi bare, hæ? Nå kommer det da jævlig partiet, det jo aldri.
Det kan jeg komme, aldri.
We use 6 hours, and they use 3. They're so in love.
It's gonna be so cozy, oh my god.
And I'm like recently not in love, or like I'm in love, but my girlfriend's not. Or my ex-girlfriend, I guess. And like we climb in the tent, me and Tara, and she's like, yeah, you know what I have? She pulls up a bottle of wine. I'm like, they're chit-chatting all night in the tent, and I'm just like trying to sleep, putting some earplugs in, and like in the cold alone. Well, that was nice for them.
Good night.
Morning. Oh, it's clearing. Nice.
Gonna be a good day.
First some coffee.
I've gone to the whole Tromsø and advised om ikke beveg deg, hva skal jeg terreng.
Holy shit.
Oh my god.
Oi, oi, oi. This is the area with the most avalanche deaths in all of Norway. And this season has been extremely bad. Feels like people have been like dying left and right.
The seracs are coming down. We're going up. Right around camp, it seems like there's avalanche prone snow. But we're gonna go up a little higher, check that zone. Kristin and Eivind are gonna go check the other aspects.
Okay, for that sist gang, så det vi jo...
Kuka, for faen.
Let's go.
Okay, ciao, ciao.
God tur.
The avalanche danger that we were dealing with was there because of rain crust and facets that had formed on top of that. We were hoping if we climbed a little higher, we would get up so high that it had been cold and you wouldn't have that same problem.
Let's dig, Eric.
El pizzeria.
Feels like we don't have those facets up here.
Doesn't feel like it, no.
I say that's a go.
Up, up we go.
Up, up we go. We're working out those sled legs.
Yep.
But halfway up this couloir, Erik kind of gets the bad vibes.
Thinking a little bit, just going over there and turning around.
It was a gut feeling. Like my first experience with riding in Lingen, I was 15 and it was a big avalanche and I had to dig out two people. I've been caught in avalanches but got out and dug out two people last year who died. Just understood that if I'm gonna do this my entire life, I have to like crank it down a little bit.
No, I think that's a good call. Yeah. I still feel okay for this last section.
Yep.
The thoughts were just getting into my head, even though I know it's pretty safe.
Ciao, ciao, Erik.
Was I missing Christer's nerves of steel? Wishing he wasn't busy staring up that death ramp on the other side of the glacier? Yeah, a little bit. But I totally respect Erik trusting his gut. Beyond our training, that's the only thing keeping us alive out there.
A lot of good riding down from here anyway. It's best just to do what feels best. Like in the end, it's just all about feeling good and staying safe.
Woo! Low tide, crux action, skinny, rocks.
This is rocky too.
Well, back in the spice. Okay, I'm up top. It's gonna be fast through the choke, but the rest looks super nice.
Oh, Nikolai, the snow was so fucking good.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go.
2, 1, drop.
Oh, good run.
Yeah, good first run. How's your day?
Good.
So what are you gonna do? Are you...
Yeah, ramp tomorrow.
You're doing the ramp tomorrow,
yeah.
Okay.
Even though it's super scary.
It's a lot of exposure.
Okay, well, I think we're gonna go ski some mini golf tomorrow.
Yeah. Like seeing you guys up there, I was like, shit, the mini golf look good.
It was 5:15 and we have a long day ahead of us.
Erik and I were gonna ride the mini golf lines off the Balgisvari Pass.
This snow is pretty good.
Which also happened to be the starting point for Eivin and Krister's long climb up Jekkevare.
Thanks for making tracks.
Yeah, of course. Stay safe up there.
You have to do yourself, kinda. But I feel it's really weird.
Nico dropping.
We're on this glacier trip. I'm doing my own project. Nico is doing his project.
Oh my lord!
I thought he was gonna tumble like a tumble dryer. Damn, you stomped that.
That was sick, dude!
Erik dropping.
Yeah, Erik.
Damn. Oh, that looks good.
They've already done two crazy good lines this morning, and we're not on the start of the ridge yet.
Är du grepp på en till efterpå eller kan du följa?
Jag vill grepp på kampen. Tell them the other fett är blaster.
Yeah.
At this point, I've lost Christer to the steeps, and now I'm losing my new partner to sled-induced fatigue. So yeah, I was feeling a little lonely up on that pinnacle.
Nico dropping.
Jonas Nikolai.
And then all of a sudden, like, I hear on the radio,
the fog is rolling in on Jekkevare, so it's a no-go for us.
We don't want to put ourselves in that situation, being on top of Jekkevare with crevasses and cliffs in a whiteout.
It sucks, but what shall I do?
Yeah, bummer. But yeah, you should ride a line over here. The snow is super good.
Yeah, I know one guy that's interested. His name is Eivind Onensen.
Here comes K-Dog. Oh, kind of glad you guys turned around. You got some of this.
You guys are killing it.
Okay, I have one idea though. So the steep boys can get some steeps. If we traverse over there, we'll get to the bottom of the gash.
The snow here is epic. Wow.
Just around the corner here.
Hold fella.
What a skipper.
Yeah.
Eivind Onensen is a good friend of mine. He's a really good skier. And we have been doing some lines in Lyngen before,
where we went really exposed on some first descents. But there's been so many close calls. I just see the worst case scenario all the time. And it's a special feeling, you know, when you have the persistent weak layer, wind slabs, and you're skiing the biggest terrain we have, you start to question everything.
Han är även droppa.
Okay.
Topside boys reunited.
Yeah, I think this one will be cool. Good like lunch run.
Yeah.
Then I'm like, ooh, I'm back with Krister now. We're back on the free ride game here. I like where this trip is going.
Okay, well, you're up if you want it.
No, no, no. I'm just here to be with you.
Yeah. Eco dropping. Time for lunch.
Lunch, boys.
I think I had like 12 liters of water ready for when the other guys came down.
You're the man, Erik.
It's like being in a hotel.
I have 6 sandwiches like this, and they're all frozen solid. Well, lunch is not as easy as you might think in minus 18.
I don't know if it's even 12 o'clock, and we've done like 4 lines.
Well, now we're joining the Nico project.
Nico project's way easier. It's all about just chilling and having a good time.
Let's go chill.
Yeah, let's go chill. Just the 5th run of the day.
It's like swimming pool of snow.
I've never had like this kind of snow in Lyngen, like for a whole trip. Everything's just blower.
Yeah.
Your run looks sick. Have fun.
Yeah, you too.
Be safe. We're gonna be topside boys, separate, but together.
Holy shit, Nico, it looks steep.
It is pretty steep.
There's a little bit of a crux going on up there, and some rocks I gotta skim past.
Nico dropping.
Oh, no way, Nico is going fast. Oh, man.
The snow is so good that even if you're in like a 50 degree slope, you can just turn them sideways and regain control kind of whenever you want.
It's super steep, but it's really, 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 really good.
Yeah, just reached the top.
How's it looking?
Now I'm on the east side of Klokketornet, on top.
When you see Klokketornet, it's just like, oh my god.
To hear Krister radio that Klokketornet was in condition.
Drop it.
That mountain was the reason I hauled that sled the whole way up on that glacier. And like, even though Krister claims he prefers slow jump turns over exposure, I could tell just by watching him ride this cool R, he was gonna have a good time on Klokketornet, if we actually got to do it.
Looks like the weather's coming in tomorrow around 10 a.m., so it'll be the last chance to ride Klokketornet.
Ah, good work, you guys.
Good pushing, here machine.
Come on up here, Aiden. Yeah, take care, ride safe.
Ciao.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lingen.
Oh, that was sick.
A lot of wind, it's pretty gnarly, like it's blowing, I can't hear what's been said on the radio, and oh shit, it's my turn now.
Yeah, Chris, there.
Oh my lord, there's over the explosion. Oh, it's fine, come on, oh, it's fine.
Holy fuck. Whoa, 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 whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa,
oh, what a morning, you guys.
That was super good.
I think we nailed this trip.
I think so, too.
Thanks for your good work up there. I hope Anders is happy, too.
Yes, I'm still spiller. I'm bashing my way up on English and Norwegian. I'll see if I can film it.